I don't even understand why so many people ask what ID is the one you're looking for, because it's like, you know when a run starts because I don't reset. Like, you don't have to be looking for the number. The only person who has to look for the number is me. I think that one was a bit early. Yeah. It's annoying because it seems like everything around the frame is really bad. So I've either got to hit it or deal with 12 turns. Yes, I can't imagine there are too many people that passionately care about whether the thumb is a finger or not. But then again, I can't imagine there's too many people who passionately care about how quickly you can beat a Pokemon game either, so... I have no intentions to run XYD at all. Not really. There we are. Mm-hmm. What's up, dude? I probably want to do more platinum. Like, I want to do any percent in round 2 in platinum. I also want to do Wario Land 2 any percent. I want to do Sonic 2 and Knuckles. And if any of my games get into ESA that I submit, I'll have to go back and redo those also. Jesus Christ, these growls. Fuck! Holy Jesus, am I happy I got the metronome. No one actually knows what the optimal rat for platinum any percent looks like, which is what makes it really exciting. Thank you. It's okay, Kisa. They're in the library too. It's not that weird. There's extra stuff, but it's not as cool as Fire Red Leaf Green. Instead of having to catch a certain amount of Pokemon, you have to see every Pokemon in the Sinnoh Dex. Then do an extra side quest, then go back to E4. I'm still unsure in a situation like this whether I should heal outside of battle right now or whether I should heal inside battle at the Starly and get hit by an extra quick attack. It's a tough call. I'm gonna do it inside the battle just because it's easier for now. Because by doing it here, I'm ensuring the Starly's going to quick attack now. So instead of being a 23, I'm at 19. Which one is better? So I'm 2 hits away from Tarn instead of 1. And in the end it didn't matter at all, because he used all 6 withdrawals. But now I do have Torrent for the first Geodude in Roark's gym.
It's hard to say.
Oh, you're kidding me. Unlikely that's still gonna work. I can try though. Maybe. The fact that I go through there is a really good sign. It's probably 50-50 whether it worked now. I think that looks right, actually. Well, we'll see in the mine for sure. Oh my god, and then I do that. Might still get the Onyx, and it didn't. Orcs? I got no encounter. I've definitely skipped over the Onyx. I guess I'll just go fight this guy. Unless this is an Onyx. Hello! That was lucky. And I have Torrent, so even though it's level 9, it'll die. Okay. But now I don't have the repel for, well, I can't keep Minit back, so I'm gonna have to buy another repel when I go backwards. So I'm gonna have to sell my Pokeballs to afford money for that. So I'll lose a few seconds doing that, but way less than I expected. I was really lucky that a level 9 Onyx showed up there. Now it's fun time with Cranidos. Yeah. Sigh. lost a bunch of time because of that bullshit. Let me out to die. Still teaching this in case I hit the spinner. It's only a couple seconds and it saves a bunch if I hit the spinner. Now Stumpy should die this turn, I think. Nice. Pretty good fight. Pretty good fight. Oh my god, I didn't teach Rock Smash. What a fucking idiot. I mean, there was something else I was supposed to do with that repel. Fucking hell. What am I doing? Thank you. Thanks, Fat Tony. I'm actually very likely. Okay, good. There's a huge chance of dying there. Nice, critical. That was a good fight, and that one usually goes really, really poorly. Fucking bitch. Thank you. The worst thing about hitting that spinner, the one that I did, is he gives such little experience, I don't even get to skip Nicholas. See, I'm still not level 19, so I still have to fight Nicholas. Well, I mean, I have to fight something, and it may as well be Nicholas. I was thinking about that Tyrant also, I was thinking about it for this run so I could like keep the Super Potion in case Pachirisu does some bullshit, but the issue is, if you're at low health, that encounter could kill you, because I mean, you don't have anything to really like devastate opponents at that stage. Like yeah, you've got Pluck, but like, say you get like a Boneri, it's not going to kill a Boneri. Obviously, if I, like, had no super potions, then I would do it. Speaking of Pachirisu doing some bullshit. Okay, Chansey, I should win. Chansey killed it, nice. Oh my god. I'm gonna lose so much time on this glitch. Actually, I did have a bad Gardenia fight on this glitch, so it is still possible that I won't lose that much. No, Chansey, that's a waste of time! I'm using a different cord, a cord that I stopped using because it wasn't working well, but I tried it out again today and it seems to be working a lot better. I don't know. Oh, that's right, I have an extra 500. Okay, so 6. Oh my fucking god. It doesn't get worse than that. Missed a 75% range into use stun spore into hit stun spore into use poison sting into poison with poison sting. I could use the potion for that, but I want to keep the potion for later in case I need it for specific torrent healing. straight to Roselia, she's fucking awesome. Oh, miss. This is a really weird fight. What a bizarre fight. Well, almost always Turtwig leads with Reflect, and it didn't use Reflect at all. It also used Sunny Day, which is incredibly rare to see. Cherrim used Magical Leaf twice, which is its least common of its three attacks. Like, yeah, really weird fight. Zooey again. Nice. Nice. Yeah, see, I'm probably going to use that regular potion before Fantina now. What? He's extended the second, really? Damn. I didn't hold right for long enough. I switched gears, so I did catch him, but I wasn't holding right. Okay, this isn't so bad, though. Because if my calculations are correct, because I hit that spinner in Mars' gym, and I had a level 9 Onyx instead of a level 7 Onyx... No, okay, this is the wrong guy. Never mind. I thought that would be enough experience to get me to level 33 after What's-A-Face, but it isn't, because it's the wrong guy. That's Jonathan, not Justin. If I hit Justin, it would have been enough. I probably would have taken it safer if I had known that, but whatever. Not a huge deal. Mars' gym. Shut up! You know what I mean. Mars, the thing before Mars. Shut up. God damn it. What I would probably do in this situation is, if I don't hit another spinner, I'll treat the guy that I usually fight for experience as the spinner in Maylene's gym, but I don't need that much, so I'll treat him as a spinner and try and skip by him, and if I miss him, fight Cindy, who's a spinner later on, because she's less dangerous than the spinner in Maylene's gym, and you have to pass Cindy 4 times. So if I just fight her on purpose on the first time, it'll actually save me some time back because I won't have to treat her as a spinner trying to dodge her all those times later on. Was really friendly. But it failed, beautiful. Probably should have just used another route, oh well.
Oops.
That's a crit. Withdraw. Kill? No. Well, fuck you. It's okay, this is what I get the revive for. And Starly needs to die at some stage anyway. Because I need to have Prinplup as my only Pokemon alive, so I can skip double battles. Look at that, and some nice torrent health there, so I can get the Bronzor. That was actually a really nice fight. Oh, whoops. Hello? Dang. Supposed to talk to that guy? Thank you. Maybe I should fight the other girl first here. In a situation like this. Maybe get an extra level, so maybe I can fucking one-hit this Roselia. Yeah, but I do like Torrent for Drifblim. I'm not gonna beat it on speed though. Hmm. Yeah, I don't know. Drifblim attacks me, I'll be in Glorious Torrent and get that one hit. And Stockpile, what a classic. That's not quite enough health for me to be safe against Machoke, so I'm gonna heal, because it's a range to kill with Torrent Bubble Beam on Machoke. This is the wrong person. Yep, I could have bought one more super. Oh well. I'll just buy maxes instead. Plus I'm level 30, so I'm gonna kill the Croagunk anyway. Damn it, I should have moved one more to the left. Hopefully Machoke still doesn't hit me and uses Leer or something, so I don't have to heal again. Oh my god, hello. Oh, I'm supposed to ether, dude. I forgot about ethering bubbles. Okay, I'll do that after Maylene. Yeah, that's exactly the same. Yeah, nice foresight. Cool. No, oh, what? I can't get through there, never mind. I don't know why I thought I could. Hello? This one. I can sneak in. Okay. That's the one I was thinking of. Nice. That was a beautiful bite. Attack, nice. that feel when heat charmed. I wouldn't mind it being attracted. That means that I can't get confused. Still don't get confused. Soft boil. I can't remember if I'm supposed to heal there or not. Yes, I am supposed to heal there. Thank God I did it. I battled her to get to level 33. So now I can do this. I usually battle the spinner in Maylene's gym, but because I didn't need that much experience on this run, I would rather fight her because I have to pass her 4 times. So by fighting her on purpose, I can just bike straight past her later on and save a bit of time that way. That feel when Brian is actually useful? Look at that. Beautiful. Didn't get hit at all, which is a bit of a double-edged sword. It means I won't have to heal before wake, which is good, but it means I almost certainly will not get Tarn for the default route. Hopefully I can stay at really high health so I don't have to heal before the Machoke as well, but that's quite unlikely. See what happens there. Asshole. Heh. Well, I just found an error in my notes. I knew there'd be some. After wake, it says, take hotel to heal here if below, and then doesn't have a number. So I obviously thought to do that in some situations, but never calculated what it actually should be. You say below 69 as a joke, but you actually have to heal to 69 plus before the Machoke, which is the second fight on that route. But it wouldn't be that. It'd be for if you're not in Torrent or if you're gonna die to the Apom. Like, how much does Apom do? 10 or 12? Apom does 12. So it'd be like 81. If you're below 81, not in Torrent. Or if you're below 12. Which is probably what's gonna happen for me here. Just spam grass knot. I'm healing, because I'm not in Torrent, and I'm going to have to heal before the Machoke, so faster to take the hotel than heal before Machoke. So I'm losing a little bit of time here because I fought that spinner on purpose. So I'm not actually really losing time, this was a good split. It's just that I didn't really make up that much time on Maylene. Just throw like 40 seconds on each side. Thanks for the update, Funsize. Three down, nice. I get to use Brian more this way as well. Save those text frames. Get off. God. More useful, Brian. Good fight. Nice! Oh, you beauty! If I can get past this spinner, this will be absolutely perfect. All three attacks that can miss, missed me. And I haven't missed an attack yet. Yes! She still comes from the right, ugh. Okay, so I should always go right. That's annoying. I didn't know that. Get in there. Thank you. That was a really, really nice segment. So it's actually, I specifically teach Surf over Pluck so that I don't have Pluck anymore. So the Krogonks with Anticipation don't shudder because Pluck is obviously super effective against them. And that's one of the more recent changes to the route that I've put in. Tiny little time saves are my favorite. Come on, baby, hit. There we go. Oh, come on. What the fuck was that? Like, you one-hit pretty much everything in, like, the back half of the game. Like, once you get Surf, there are very few things you don't one-hit anyway. The only thing that's coming to mind is the Tropius on the Snow Rat. You might one-hit everything else in the game. Oh no, Cyrus is Gyarados. Cyrus 3 is Gyarados, you don't one hit. Oh yeah, the Mantine. Good call, Sinstar. The Mantine on the way to Victory Road, yep. 3 pokes. Do you want, the Mirror Empoleon is a range even with Torrent, as is the Altaria in Victory Road. But I mean, the point I'm making is it really wouldn't be that much different. Nice. That works. Oh, whoops. Ah, fuck. Oops. Hello? Sweet scent, nice. Just really didn't want to mess that one up. And I was very close to doing so. In many ways. Fucking wave, dude. That's really bad, because now I'm not going to be Torrent for the next fight also. Look at me, not in Torrent. Just crit, dude, just crit. That isn't critting, I'm afraid. I'm gonna have to flash cannon. Second Golbats, I guess. That Frostlass has Snow Cloak, so it is actually possible to miss it. So that is always a heart and mouth moment. Damn. Okay, I may as well surf this guy. I've got the PP for it. Okay, I can sell X-Speed Cyrus now though, because I've got the extra experience, which is nice. God fucking damn it. God damn it, dude. Stop doing dumb things, please. Much better. Thank you. I don't think anyone expected him to turn it on twice. I think everyone's just happy it happened once. Hello? Damn it. It's a waste of time. Yep. Oh god, I thought that was them, but it was the rappel. Thank you. Heracross! Aw, damn it. Heracross can live. It saves a really small amount of time because you skip the text box where it says Heracross dies. That feel when you actually want to miss a damage range? If it was just my sum of best, then it would say sum of best. Thank you.
Yep.
Damn. The crit. Very nice. That makes up for that will-o-wisp. Oh, whoops. That's not when I split. I thought it didn't make sense that I was making up time there. Okay. I split a Giratina. tying its opponent warily. Thank you. Alright, Megan, be a friend. Thank you. I probably shouldn't pause for the first spin of that guy, since I have to pass him 3 times. Alright, good. Got past both of them. Got my sights set on 343 here. Got the wave. Okay, got through. Miss. Okay, so high health, so we're not getting torrent. Just have to crit Altari and run Empoleon, I guess. Oh god. Stop! Stop! Okay, bike's in fourth, third. I didn't take off specs! I didn't take off specs! Okay, that's not so bad. This is fine. I can just strength here, take off specs at the other spinoff. Where's strength? Okay, I'm fine. It's fine. I can do it later. That's fine. Okay. Takedown is good. That Mantine has an array of shit moves. Bounce. Confusion shit. All good. Thank you. Oh god. Alright, now this is a Pokemon I wouldn't mind critting. Another one here, let's see if I can get Empoleon. Yeah, I'm not gonna one-hit Snorlax. But because I've taken so little damage, because I got Focus Blast Miss from, Volkner, even a crit Earthquake won't kill me. So I'm not gonna set up the X Special on Float, so I'm just gonna use Surf. Because it's faster to just use two Surfs than set up an X Special. Using an item takes longer than just attacking. And plus, this way I do get the chance to crit as well, and potentially just save the turn. Oh, what? That's not what I wanted, but whatever. I mean, I was supposed to deposit Empoleon. I was just supposed to do it before I changed the glove. So I would just store instead of picking him up. Now this time I actually have supers. So I'll use one super after Flint with that with the max elixir, and probably not heal on Bronzong on Lucian, and super up before Cynthia. Good, got Vespiquen. That's actually a 15 and 16 range, so it can live. The only potential useful crit on E4 is that one that I just mentioned, Vespiquen. Or, if I decide to play really risky on Cynthia, her Milotic. If I play risky, her Surf, oh, my Surf, sorry, is a 13 and 16 range on Milotic. But if I play safe, it's guaranteed kill. Everything else is guaranteed kill. I mean, whether I play risky or safe depends on whether it'll actually gain me any time. Like, if playing risky will gain me an extra minute, yeah, I'm gonna do it. If it won't, then I won't. that simple. This is an awful amount of health. Is 66 still current? Yes. Oh wait, do I get a level up? Oh fuck. Does Mr. Mime give me a level up? Probably will. So it's probably the right decision to not heal. Yeah, Mr. Mime's gonna need me a level up. Not gonna heal. Oh, I forgot to split. Okay. But I do still have to max elixir. I went backwards instead of forwards. God damn it. Now Bertha doesn't have a split either. Not like it matters, I can just input them later. That was a low roll, which is good. Am I in quick attack range? Yes or no? No. So I'm just gonna surf through and super after.
Okay.
Being a pansy bitch there and using 3 super potions instead of 2, simply because I have nothing to lose. I can't save an extra second here. So I may as well prevent myself from getting like special death dropped into some bullshit. Done. Well, I mean, Lucario has extreme speed, so I actually can't be on, like, 4 health here. It doesn't matter whether I use the super or not, this is gonna be a 342. So I figured I may as well use it. And not get, like, crit special death drop and then have to heal and end up getting a 343. Excellent. That's a really good time. I'm really happy with that. My early game wasn't the best, But I'm happy with that time. My mid game was exceptionally good. Good late game as well. E42, you beauty. Would have been about 342.36 would be about the seconds, so a mid 342. Really nice, really nice. I mean, obviously not a perfect run, but I'm happy with that. That's good. Really happy. Oof. Alright, so time to move on. So we'll see if I can get my 3DS capture card to stream, because if it can, I would stream me beating Super, because that'll probably come today. And, would probably jump on the red, blue, yellow VC releases just to see if there's any differences or whatever. But that isn't working at the moment, so that's probably not on the agenda. I still want to keep playing Platinum, but just not any percent Glitchless. I want to have a look at any percent and Round 2. Round 2 has some runs. Tyrant has done the most notable of runs there. So Round 2 in Platinum is you have to see every Pokemon in the Sinnoh Dex, so you have to go around fighting a lot more trainers to complete that, and then do Stark Mountain, and then do Round 2. I think that's pretty interesting. And any percent is really interesting, because no one knows what's the best way to do any percent. So any percent in Platinum, again, like in Gen 4, the only glitch you can do is tweaking. And you can't really skip anything huge in Platinum. You can't skip any of the gyms, or like, do some bullshit to go straight to the Elite Four. But you can skip, like, Distortion World, and some of the plasma shit. And another thing you can do is you can tweak directly into Pal Park, and to get into Pal Park you normally have to have the Sinnoh Dex completed, and so by going into the Pal Park early you can actually activate a cutscene which releases the Gen 1 legendary birds, and so you can release a level 60 Moltres and then go catch him. And so that's a potential strat, is to get an early Moltres and blaze through with him. Yes, galactic shit, I mean. But we'll see what ends up happening there. In regards to other games that I want to run, ESA submissions close on February 27, and so I'm going to submit games for that. I'm not exactly sure what I'm going to submit, but the five games I'm thinking of at the moment are Sonic 2 and Knuckles, which I'm going back to regardless of whether it gets in, because I do want to get that record back. Sonic CD, the original one, Sonic 2 for the Master System, Tails Adventure, and Pokemon Mystery Dungeon Red Blue. If any of the latter four get in, then I'll have to go back to them to review, so I'm in good form for that. Outside of that, I do want to go to Wario Land 2 any percent, and to get that one back, In regards to other Pokemon games, pretty much the only thing I'm thinking about right now is Black White 1, because it's the only game I haven't run that I am actually interested in running, but it does seem a bit boring. We'll see if it seems more interesting when I get back to it, but that's not on the near horizon. Pokemon on the near horizon is still Platinum. I want to do any percent in round 2. That was a really nice run, though. 342. I mean, it wasn't perfect, but I wasn't going for perfect. No one's ever going for perfect. 342 is a really nice time. Especially considering when I started playing, the record was 356. To bring it down, like, 14 minutes. It's really nice. I don't think this will get brought down another 14 minutes. I'll put it that way.